find some cover.
All right, so basically this game is based on the TV show, but is also a poor man's XCOM. As you can see, the design is very, very, very similar to XCOM. You can choose to attack, move, attack, defend, reload, swap weapons, cover area, shoot nearby enemy that moves. It is literally poor man's XCOM, and I am not complaining about that. And see how it's got a blue line for where you can move and yellow for how far you are? It's so, so similar to XCOM, it's ridiculous. But I am not complaining. It's worth it, you know?
On my way.
You know, if you like your little poor man's XCOM. Movement to the blue region consumes one action point.
We're still too exposed.
I know we are. Well, let's get behind full cover
on
then.
My way.
So you got a choice between half cover and full cover, exactly similar to XCOM. Move your next squad member to another position. There you go. I don't think any of the original voice actors came to voice this game, but I'm not too bothered anyway because they're not really big voice actors. Like, not many of them I actually knew who they were.
Okie dokie.
But it was a, it was quite a cheap TV show.
On it.
But it did very well with its budget.
Hold on, I hear something.
Oh, here we go. Oh shit.
To the entrance without being spotted.
Alright, move your squad up to get a better vantage point. The Ashveni phase? That's fine. Alright, so far it's just going to tell us what we're doing so far, so we don't really have any room for failure. Right, I'm going to set him to defend.
Pay attention.
Yep, just pay attention. Right, you take cover behind that bench. James Combs. I forget all the names. I really do. I don't know who's who. They'd have to show a picture in order for me to know who it is. Laurie Hodge. Again, no idea.
Got it.
Oh, here they come again. Oh shit, there's a whole bunch of them.
Watch yourselves.
Oh shit, there's one. Oh fuck, he's coming.
It's just a scratch.
Son of a bitch. Laurie Hodge is bleeding.
Stop that skitter before we can warn
fucking skitters. Alright. We'll attack him.
Make the next one count.
You missed. Accuracy improves as you get closer to the target. Use a squad to take out.
Just like that.
There you go. It's a poor man's XCOM. Don't know what else to expect, really. You're pretty... I think we'll attack you.
That's it?
Got the enemy skitter.
We need to find out what the Ashveni are building.
Right, we'll move you up then. Take cover behind that planter.
Okay.
They got similar sounding voice actors, which is pretty neat.
On my way.
Alright, you should... defend.
Really?
Really? Oh shit, you're bleeding. Alright, fuck it. Move up.
On my way.
Right, you're stupidly far behind, so you run up there.
Done.
Well, fuck it.
Here I come.
Greetings, fellow survivors of
Oh god. It's Pope. Or whatever his name was.
You know what that means? Viva la Parte.
That's Pope's
yep,
voice.
Pope.
That device is tracking our camp communication.
What an asshole.
We have to shut it down.
Damn it, Pope. Why are you always fucking our shit up?
Watch me fly.
Still bleeding out. It looks like you can only cover area with a full move.
Nothing's getting through here.
You can't cover with a half move. That's a little bit shit. Wait. Why can't he cover from here? He isn't on a half move. I'm confused. That makes no sense. He shouldn't be on a half move. Why is he on a half move? Ah, whatever.
I'm on it.
I'll put you there. You can defend the location there. Go there, and L2, I guess?
I think we did a good job.
Yay! Move your squad to the extraction point. Okay. Well, it's pretty much... It's a discount, XCOM. What do you expect? So... There you go.
I'm going Move now. Out.
You can also rotate the screen, similar to XCOM.
And rotate.
Oh, the Esfeni are coming. Oh, looks like one of them are coming. Oh! Looks like I got him. Nice. Did I manage to hit him? Did I hit him? Oh, I hit him! Nice! We got an enemy skitter. Oh, shit. This skitter's coming. Alright. I've got a little friend for you, my friend. Here you go. How's that? Taste grenade, bitch. Easy peasy lemon squeezy. Right, I'll move you there.
Roger that.
Be nice if I could swap characters similar to XCOM. If I could swap characters similar to XCOM, that'd be pretty sick. But unfortunately, I can't.
Okay.
Looks like they stopped bleeding, so that's okay. So how many of you guys have actually seen Falling Skies? And what did you guys think of this TV show? I thought it was pretty interesting, personally. You know? Looks like we're pushing forward. I always found some of the situations to be pretty unrealistic. It's like, how did you survive that? It was like magic.
Here I come.
But other than that, it was pretty sweet. Yeah, I had an interesting premise behind it. Alright. There's Fenny phase, because no one else is coming. I'm not too worried. Alright, so all I need you now is to go in here. Cover area. Oh, I guess only he can cover areas, maybe. Oh, I guess so. Okay.
On my way.
Okay.
Which is funny, because he's not really that much of a soldier. He never was. He was a teacher. He was more of a leader. But we took them out. Mission complete. We did good. So that was a good introduction to Falling Skies the game, which is pretty much just poor man's XCOM. It really is. It's not too bad at all. Never played it before. I just remember seeing it on YouTube a few times, because I was interesting to see if this TV show ever had a video game. When I found out it did, I was like, what the fuck? This TV show's got a video game. A video game! What the fuck? Why would this TV show get a video game? But it's actually pretty interesting, actually.
Heard the fish heads were found tinkering again at the local mall. What was it this time, huh? An interstellar soda
fuck
machine?
Fuck you, Pope.
It looked like some sort of shortwave radio tracker.
A tracker?
You think they've discovered us?
They did okay getting the likeness of the cast.
I think we shut it down before they could pass on our coordinates.
But you can't be sure now, can you? Which means Cooties and Max could be storming our castle any second now.
Is this in the school?
With Weaver and the others away, we can't afford to take any chances. So be on guard.
Heard.
So yeah, pretty cool. Did it get the likeness? All right, it's not too bad. Good old mech suits. So fun. But I do like that they actually used the idea behind XCOM, because XCOM is itself a very similar premise to Falling Skies. It's quite similar. We got some resources, which is cool. All right, so we've got Tom, Tess, James Coombs, and Laurie Hodge. I can't remember Laurie Hodge. I remember Tess. She was pretty badass. Or is it Laurie I'm thinking of? I can't remember, if I'm honest. But, doesn't look like him at all. Change the character's skills. Why would I want to do that? I'm quite happy with him being a cover area guy. Allows the fighter to attack or defend after sprinting. That'd be kind of handy. Defend reduces the fighter's chance to be hit by 40%. Oh, sweet. So, Tess can learn to be take careful aim, increasing the accuracy of shot by 10%. Pretty handy, pretty awesome. Next unit. Looks like Laurie... I think I remember Laurie, didn't she... Oh, spoilers. Yeah, I think I remember her. I think I do, anyway. I kind of liked her at the end. It's pretty cool. Yeah, she was one of the berserkers. Alright, so we've upgraded the skills. That's fine. I'm okay with that now. Alright. Alright, so 4 volunteers are available to recruit. So you kind of see the similarities between it and XCOM again. You've got the War Room, which is literally the War Room from XCOM, which is pretty fucking hilarious. You've got the armory, of course. We just haven't built these places. It's really cool, though. Alright, so it looks like we've got a whole bunch of recruits. I don't know if these guys are from the TV show or not. I really couldn't say. I guess these guys are generic people. I don't know. But they're just level ones. They're nothing special. Nothing to really upgrade them. We need a bit more food to upgrade that. We've got a workshop, which is pretty cool. Looks like we can make some light vests. Very similar to XCOM. Again, there's so many similarities to XCOM. They basically just used XCOM as a template. It's really good. Infirmary. I think there should be one person healing in here, surely. A memorial. And there's a memorial, which is hilarious, for the fallen heroes. I actually kind of like that. I remember that from the TV show. That was interesting as fuck. They put loads of names on that fucking tree, didn't they? That was so good. Although I'm not sure if it was in that area. Alright, can I give people custom names? Just out of curiosity. It would be nice. I actually might put people from the chat in there. But only if I can. If I can't rename them, then there's no point, is there? Alright, can I rename you? Customize. Customize appearance. Name. Here we go. Here you go. Hey, Holy Helm. Just like XCOM. There you go, bro. Holy Helm. I'm not going to change how you look, because I can't be bothered with that. But yeah, if you want to be inside of the game right now, now's your chance to pipe up. Pipe up, let me know, and I will literally add you to the game right now. Because that's actually pretty cool. I kind of like that feature. So this is a nice little streaming feature in the game that was completely unintentional, of course, but you can make your own custom. Curious. Could I? It doesn't look like it. Can you rename Tess? You can rename Tess. Interesting. I guess if they're unimportant characters, I can rename them, but I can't customize the other two characters, what's his name and his son. So that's pretty interesting. So I do like that. Alright, so what's in the menu? Save game. Well, of course we want to save the game, so we'll do that. Not that we've done anything, but it's always handy to save. I like that it's got an in-game save system. Not being lazy and using the default PlayStation 1. It always took me out of the game with that. Bethesda was notorious for it. Bethesda, why? Why don't you use your own save system? Alright, let's go to the war room. Let's kick some ass. Alright, send a squad to complete missions, or send an individual on dispatch mission to collect resources. Now that's pretty interesting. No character has been selected. Characters sent on dispatch mission will be unavailable until a squad mission is completed. So it's kind of similar to missions in Assassin's Creed, where you just got your units and sent them off on missions to come back, which is pretty cool. So, Holyhelm? No, I'll keep you. I'll keep you, don't worry. Right, I'm going to send this unit. I'm going to dispatch them to go look for resources. Yep, and it looks like we can only have one person on dispatch at a time. Alright, squad mission. Alright, so we have to... Our mission right now is to locate a convoy, which we're going to do. There is only one... rule, and that is Tom must survive. I take it his son's not coming with him. Interesting. So we were expecting a convoy from a nearby settlement to arrive today. They've been checking in regularly, but we lost contact with them a few hours ago. The convoy was only a few miles from here when we last heard from them. Search the roads. Ah, shit. Probably gonna die. Right, select the squad. Alright. I'm gonna replace James with Holyhelm. Holyhelm, you're coming on with us. There we go. Don't make me regret it. So it looks like we're not taking Tom's son, whatever his freaking name is. It's been years since I've watched the show. The show ended many years ago. I mean, when was this game released? 2014? Really? 2014? I guess the TV show ended around that time then. Or maybe 2015. I'm not too sure. You're gonna die? It's the first mission. I'd be surprised if you die. But there is a memorial wall. So you've got that to think about. Pretty awesome beans though. See, you know for a discount XCOM, that's not bad.
Don't forget, we stick together.
We stick together? I completely disagree. Now this just screams XCOM. Tell me this does not scream XCOM. Right, Tom, you move up here. Alright, and you cover area.
Nothing's getting through here.
No problem.
Alright, you go there. Defend.
Wait for it.
Alright, I'm gonna put you there.
Going down.
Yeah, get over it, Holyhelm. And Laurie Hodge, you head up here.
Let's do this.
She's got a freaking rocket launcher. Right, the Asfeni aren't showing up, though. They're not showing up just yet. Right. Alright, could you... Ooh. The controls are a bit... iffy, if I'm honest. They are a bit iffy. Alright, you go there.
Got it.
Alright, Holyhelm, you stay there. You defend that spot.
I can do this.
You can do this, and you will do this, or I'll kick your ass. Alright, you go up there.
En route.
Alright. I recommend there.
On my way. Look alive. We've got company.
Oh shit, who's that? What? No targets in range. Let's change that, shall we?
You got it. Just like that.
Just like that. I love how he just stands there and he's like, just like that. Right, pull back here.
On my way.
She's part of the Asfeni for some reason. Looks like she's one of the children. Oh shit.
Nothing to worry about.
Nothing to worry about? Oh shit, we got another Asfeni coming. Everything will be fine. Hmm. She can't see them. They're completely... Oh! You can somehow see them. Holy hell! You got a kill. So there was a harnessed human there. That is concerning. Alright, I'm gonna bring... that one down here. I need you to go there.
Okay.
Yep, go there. Alright. Defend.
Gotta pay attention.
Pay attention. That's all you need to do. Alright. What I'm going to do is I'm going to bring you down, Holy Helm. I'm going to move this lady up here.
On my way.
She can hold a position there. I'll take half cover behind the log. Anyone comes in, shoot their ass.
Getting through here.
Right, Holy Helm, you push on up there.
Got it.
Right, a Sveni phase. Oh, here comes one of them. Here he comes. Oh. Oh. Nice. We almost killed him. Almost killed him. Did good. You reckon you can finish him? 41%? Yeah.
Make the next one count.
Keep it up. Right, we took out another harnessed human. This isn't looking good, though. Harnessed humans are a bad, bad sign. Right, for now, you just hold your position. Holy Helm, you move up.
Let's go.
No, this is a pretty neat game. I do like it. This is not bad at all.
Got it.
Looks like I'm gonna push up. We're all gonna push up north.
Something's wrong here. We should have spotted the convoy by now.
A Sveni phase. Oh, here we go. Nope. Nothing. Nothing still.
On it.
Alright. I'm gonna push everyone up here.
You got it.
Alright. Holy Helm, could you...
Okie
dokie me. Alright. You push up.
On it.
Oh. Oh shit. Oh shit. Oh shit. How can you not see it? Ah shit. Well, she's gonna get hit. Ah, shit. This Sveni's gonna attack you.
That all you got?
Oh shit, it's those fucking bugs. At least they're not hitting very hard. Alright. Need to pull her back. I don't know if we can do friendly fire. 60% chance of hitting. Holy Helm, do you have a better shot? 50%? I'll take your 50. There you go. Enemy crawlies taken care of. Not bad, Holy Helm. Not bad. Alright, need you to just move up for us.
Got it.
Looks like we're heading towards this bridge.
Watch me fly.
Right, you hold that position, lady. Move everyone up.
Headed out.
Right, move up to that log. Go.
You got it.
Just following the road, trying to find the convoy. Alright, you see Batman? Yes, yes you do. And right next to him is Superman. Don't know how well you can see that with the microphone and that, but Superman is stood right next to him. They are the giant Man of Steel and Dark Knight figures. I do want the Wonder Woman one. You just defend the... Wait, who are we moving? Oh, her. Nah, defend that location.
Really?
Yes, really. But yeah, this is a really neat game. Alright. Mm. Right, Holy Helm, because you're furthest back, I'm going to send you furthest forward.
Let's go.
Get across the bridge. Right. Oh, shit. You've triggered something. Are those humans or harnessed people?
The convoy's been ambushed.
Shit. 9%? That's not good enough. Tom, do you have something? 42%? I'll take that.
That's it.
Finish him. Good one, Tom. Good one. But yeah, this game's really freaking good. For what it is, it's really good.
Done.
Right, you run on up. Right. Reckon you can get a shot? It's 80%? Hell yeah.
That should have been a bigger hit.
That should have been a bigger hit. The hell was that? Right, move up there.
Heard.
Can you get a shot on? You can. Do it.
I don't know what happened.
I don't know what happened either. You suck. The Esfeni. What's the Esfeni gonna do? Oh shit, launching! Shit! Savage swipe? What the fuck? Tess is bleeding? Ah, shit. Tom! Actually, Holy Helm, you're the one with the shotgun. 60% chance? Holy Helm, I swear to God, if you miss this. Fucking garbage.
Doing my job.
Did I say it followed? It's showing up for me. Not too sure. Might not be working. But if you are following, thank you for the follow. I really do appreciate it. We're currently doing 1 hour per game. I'm going through my entire backlog. We're currently on PlayStation 3 at the moment. So, I'm going through all the games I haven't played before. Falling Skies, the video game, is one of them. And it's literally discount XCOM. It is very good.
Okay.
I do like it. Right, push forward.
On my way.
Alright, we've saved the survivors. The Esfeni flays. Hopefully she doesn't get swamped. Right, you push forward.
On my way.
Alright, Tom. You reload.
Ready.
Alright.
On it.
Right, we've got the medical supplies.
I'm on it.
Alright. I'm gonna move Holy Helm up.
Okay.
My aim is a little off. You missed twice. Get good.
Time to move.
Right, you get into the middle of them, you should handle it. Right. She's still bleeding out. Are they coming? Doesn't look like they're coming. I don't think there's any way to heal her. We haven't come up against a healer. Oh well. Right, we've grabbed the medical. Mission complete? Is that it? We don't have to extract? I'd extract if you want me to, game. No? That's okay. What's this called? Oh, yeah, it's called Falling Skies, the game. Falling Skies is a TV show. Was a TV show. It had about five or six seasons, and it actually finished in, like, 2014, 2015. It was quite a good TV show. It's based on... basically, aliens have invaded Earth. And won. They kicked the Earth's ass.
Survivors we rescued from the convoy are all settled in.
It's pretty much XCOM.
The medical supplies we
it's a TV show like XCOM, I guess.
Thanks.
We also and the game is very, very similar to XCOM.
Looks like a Esfeni tech. What is it?
I believe it's some sort of power source.
Power source.
And you are? This is Dr. Simon Bahari. He was with the convoy. Before the invasion, he was an engineer at the National Renewable Energy Laboratory.
NREL. Didn't they do research on alternative energy? Solar heating, geothermal power.
That's right.
How convenient.
Where did you find this?
Our convoy passed through Boston several weeks ago. We were foraging for supplies in the wreckage of a destroyed Esfeni command tower.
Yeah, someone sure gave it to the fish heads real good.
So you think this capsule is what exactly?
An alien battery, more or less.
An Ishvini battery. This could change everything. We could start to.
You didn't finish it, but you've watched it. Hey, at least you've seen it. That's all that matters. But yeah, this is the video game based on it.
Hal's crazy girlfriend's dead, and the Ishvini are scrambling. If we got that kind of power, we should be using it to blow the fish heads out of the water. Right, not enough for keeping the air conditioning.
Exactly. I agree with you, Pope.
There's a bigger picture here to think about, Pope. A life beyond the Ishvini. I mean, this thing could power an entire city.
If we don't start fighting a dirtier war, Sunshine, there won't be any life beyond the Ishvini.
Pope isn't wrong.
Well, what's it
Despite Pope's character, he did make a lot of sense.
Pope's right. Dr. Bahari, can this battery be used to build a weapon?
It's conceivable, yes.
Anthony, see to it that Dr. Bahari gets whatever
The sound quality in this game is quite poor. Especially the voice. The voice sound quality is really poor. I don't know why that is. I'm guessing it's just poor recordings. But other than that, it's not a bad game. It's not awful. At least I'm enjoying it. I love XCOM, you see, so I can't go wrong with that. Mission complete. Pretty cool beans. Looks like you guys leveled up. Holy helm! You're a spiked kid! That's fucking awesome. Spiked kids are really, really agile, quite durable, heal really quickly. I don't know how that'll affect the game, per se. But, yeah, that's pretty cool stuff. Apparently, I don't get a choice in what skills Tom gets. Fair enough. Whatever. Alright, so we got some more skills for Tessa. Now, we got a choice here. For level 3, we can allow the scout to move an additional grid square per AP, pretty sweet, or get pistol damage and accuracy is increased by 30%. Now for a sniper, that'd be pretty freaking impressive. So I'm not too sure. Being able to move more, I think accuracy and damage would probably be more beneficial. So we'll train that. There we go. Alright, next unit. Alright, Holy Helm, you are... Well, because you're a spiked kid, you have a free skill of class. Melee weapon which performs a devastating attack at close range. So basically, you run in head first, Holy Helm. You run in head first, and you stab a motherfucker in the face. And your secondary skill, let's have a look, for level 3, adds an extra utility slot, allowing a spiked kid to carry more utility items, really fucking handy, and then allows a spiked kid to stack 3 of the same utility into one slot. Ooh. Now, to carry 2 items, or 3 of 1 item? 3 of 1 item. We'll have you as the medic, if we get any medics. I don't know. I've not come across a medic yet. Next up, we have Laurie. Laurie upgraded as well. She's a berserker, so automatically attack any enemy that scores a critical hit on a berserker. Improves defense while suppression is active. I imagine that's for when she's being suppressed. That doesn't necessarily mean you'll hit them. More defensive bonus, I guess. Keep them alive longer. Alright, pretty cool beans. Alright, I want to craft some... Oh, someone's returned from an away mission. Surefire slugs. Pistol slugs. Time, one mission, tuna metal. A reliable solution when you need to hit the target and hit it hard. Basic but effective armor, light enough to be worn by all unit classes. I like that. Gimme. I'm gonna make myself that. No one should be in the infirmary, I don't believe. Got any upgrades? I don't know. I need 1,000 medical supplies to get trauma trainee. This compact bundle bandages contains... There's all sorts of stuff. When all else fails, this portable device has a chance to restart a fatally wounded patient's heart. Wow. Personal reduces all damage taken by 5%, and it's a passive. Wounded soldiers receive a temporary boost to maximum health for one mission. Right, we need to get some roll of bandages made. So, we need to get some more medical supplies. War room. Dispatch mission. So she came back with 100 plus resources. Not too bad. I'm going to dispatch her again. Well, this time we'll dispatch Shana. Don't know who you are, but you can piss off. Go on, get out of here. Piss off. Alright, squad mission. We're up. Alright, so we have a choice now. We have quite a choice. We have a choice to engineer a rescue. So, one of our engineers is holed upon his ship. A squad assigned to protect him fell when the Isfeni staged a swift attack. The engineer is hiding out among the shipping containers of the deck. He remains undetected for now, but that could change at any moment. We'll board the ship and rescue him. We get some medical supplies and metal. If we cootie clearance, the shopping district indicated here is overpopulated with skitter troops. Their numbers seem to be steadily increasing. They're getting too close to camp for comfort. We cannot allow them to encroach further on our territory. Work your way through this area and clear them all out. Well, I want some medical supplies. Fighting dirty. In the zone indicated where we spotted stacks of barrels filled with industrial waste, our engineers requested a sample for their weapons research. Anything that might give us an edge over the Isfeni is worth exploring. Don't open the barrels without any protective gear on. It's nasty stuff. Ooh. Not too worried about food, I don't think. We'll go rescue a guy. That sounds fun. Let's go rescue him. Alright, so we're taking Holy Helm with us. We're not taking Tom with us, apparently. We're going to take Sean Kidd. Sean Kidd? I don't know. I'm going to replace Tess, I think. We need to get a couple more people trained up, so I'm going to take James Combs. Sounds good to me. We'll take a couple of level ones with us. Holy Helm and Laurie, I hope you guys know what you're doing and show them the ropes. This should be relatively easy. But, the game could get harder, just like XCOM. You never know. You never know. With a game like this, you just don't know. So yeah, this game is not awful. It's not awful. It's got its own thing going, which is interesting. I'm not too sure. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. Ba-da-ba-ba. The one thing I don't like about this game is probably the loading times. But then again, can't be helped, I suppose. Alright, board the ship and rescue the engineer. Alright. So what are we looking at with this map? Suppose... go up there. Alright, so it looks like we've got an indoor area. I'm not sure what kind of loot we can get. Let's just push everybody forward, I reckon.
Will do.
Don't really need to keep cover or anything. Okay. Just run everyone forward.
Okey-dokey.
Run up the stairs, have a quick look. I want to see what we're dealing with. Try not to get shot in the face.
Let's do this.
Isfeni phase. Alright, so far so good. I'll send the newbie up. He can take cover.
I'm there.
Go.
For you.
Looks like we can board the ship there. You go take cover next to him.
Going.
Holy Helm. Raid that building. Shit. Shit, shit, shit. Can you get an angle on him?
Watch me fly.
I'm gonna try and get an angle on him. Doesn't look like we can. Alright, get there.
Heard.
Holy Helm's gonna get hit.
Stop that.
I don't know.
Better luck next time.
Missed. Nice. Alright, newbie, what attack do you have? 29%. That's not exactly good, is it? 38, 36? Is it 36? Oh, up to 38 damage. 36%. Go for it. Hey, you got him. Nice. Saved your ass, Holy Helm. You go up there, Holy Helm.
Let's go. Let's...
Oh shit. Holy Helm, you can get him. You can get him. Do it. Don't fail. Holy Helm, you saved your own ass. So proud. So proud. So proud of you. Defend there will be.
Really?
Yeah, really. Step up to there. Defend the spot.
Defensive positions.
I can do this.
Alright, I'm gonna send a newbie over here.
You got it.
I wanna know what's up there.
Got it.
Holy Helm, you go with him.
Here I come.
Oh shit, here we go. Looks like a skid has decided to wake up. Alright.
I hate waiting around.
I know you hate waiting, but right, you, you go over there.
Okie dokie.
See, it looks like they're coming around from the other side. Over there somehow. Interesting. All right.
I can do this.
Right, so there's the Sfenny there, doing his own thing. Oh, looks like he's on his way. Holy fucking... What? What? How did he run that far? What the fuck? What sort of fucking...
Consider it done.
That's not what I pressed on, you cunt.
Over there?
You better be able to shoot that fucking thing. Are you serious? Well, if you can't hit him, grenade him. Piece of shit. Alright. Breach the ship. Oh, we can't breach the ship. Okay. So I was trying to breach it on... You know, for no reason.
I'm going now.
I'm gonna send the noob up. Oh, looks like we've got another corpse up there.
Roger that. Time to
party. Oh shit, oh shit. Oh shit. Oh, you telling me you don't have a fucking hit?
Whatever you need.
Shit. Oh fuck. Oh fuck. Watch out, watch out, watch out. That was barely hit you, actually. Alright, how are we talking? 48%? Alright, newbie, you got this.
Make the next one count.
Yeah, better make it count.
I know you can do this.
You suck. You're garbage.
Uh-huh.
Ah, oh, fuck it. Take him out.
Light him up.
Alright, we took them out. They shouldn't be attacking us again.
Got it.
Please tell me you can shoot him from there. God damn it, Holy Helm. Grenade him. Fuck you, particular. Right, enemy harness person neutralized. Moving up.
En route. Heard.
Oh shit, not again. Keep getting hit by those fucking creepy crawlies. I know you've been hit, don't worry about it. You're gonna get hit again, don't worry about it. Okay,
scratch.
That sucked. Take him out. ...22% unacceptable. 50% unacceptable. 100%.
Another one down.
Right, dead creepy crawlies. Alright, next up. Alright. See, I'm kind of enjoying this game.
Let's go.
Doesn't look like there's any more skidders over there, so it looks like we'll be breaching the ship from up there. Right, move ahead, go. Trying to get your ass kicked on the way.
Watch me fly.
Yeah, go up there, take some cover.
You got it.
Alright, so we'll be boarding that ship. Right, we'll send the newbie in first. Always send the
Let's go.
Oh shit, oh shit. Is that the ship we're trying to board?
There they are.
Oh shit. Alright, major issue. Can you get a shot on him? No, you can't. Alright.
Going.
Can you get a grenade out on one of them? Certainly try it. Try it. Nice. I want to give that a go.
Consider
I'm put you there, and I'm going to throw a grenade over. Can I bullshit that? Oh, I didn't kill him. Oh, shit. Yeah, may as well reload.
Locked and loaded.
A bit too far away. Just defend for now.
When does the fun part start?
The fun part will start soon. Is she gonna... Oh, is that a grenade? You heal? Son of a bitch! Oh, a revenge shot. Rude. Oh shit. Oh shit, they're coming up. Those skitters can haul ass, though. I don't like that. Oh shit! They've doubled up. They shouldn't have done that. Oh, you're so fucked. Oh, you're so fucked now. Wrecked, bitch! So good. Can we get another hit on someone else? Yeah, give it a go.
Do I need glasses or something?
Yeah, sometimes. Looks like you can only attack that one, but what about you, sir? You reckon you can kill him? Alright, tell you what. I reckon if we pulled them back. But then again, you might not be able to shoot him. I'll give it a go.
We need more practice. It's all about targeting.
Alright, you just unleash hell.
I think someone bumped me.
You know what? Fuck that person. Enemy harnessed human down. Right, who's next? Alright, we've got Holy Helm up here, but I'm not too sure if he'd be able to get a shot out from up here.
Let's go.
He can try.
Got him.
Got a shot out. Not too bad. Alright, he's gonna come in and smack him in the face, isn't he? Oh yeah.
Something hurt.
Oh damn. Oh, that fucking hit. That was nasty. Finish him.
Make the next
Don't you dare miss again. Out of ammo? Oh, you fucking...
Let's go.
Yeah, lit up.
I don't think it'll hold anymore.
That's fine. Alright. We'll move you up.
Going.
Heard.
Alright. That's all of them. Just gonna move up now. Sveni phase. That's no worries. Alright. So yeah, this is pretty much just XCOM. It is XCOM.
Okie dokie.
That's gonna suck. Oh shit. Oh fuck. Oh fuck. Get up there. Go. Can you get a shut out? Nice.
That's right. Making it happen.
Good shot. That was a good shot, that. That was making it happen. Great work. Right, moving on up. What boost have we got? Put you in the middle of nowhere.
You got it.
See what you can do with that.
Here I come.
Alright, put you up there.
Let's go.
See what we can do here. Yes, Fenny phase. Well, when it comes to corpses, I know for a fact they're gonna pop out and say hi. Alright, so there's nothing we can do on that side. So we're probably going to have to end up. What the fuck? Why is up here a thing? Whatever.
Uh-huh.
You, go get a vantage look.
I see them.
Yeah, I see them too. Hang on. Alright. Hey kid, reckon you can take him out?
Now just rinse and repeat.
Rinse and repeat. Good man. Alright.
On my way.
Looks like that corpse might have someone in. Don't quite like the idea of that. Right, you push forward. Hopefully we don't get attacked by anything. Go. Alright. Hopefully he stops bleeding soon. He's gonna die otherwise. Alright. Kid, up there.
I'm going now.
Oh, looks like we got a harnessed human over there.
I guess I didn't practice enough.
No. You didn't practice enough. Get good.
Not good enough. That's right. Making it happen.
Alright, there's another one down. Alright, you push forward. We'll see what we can do.
Just tell me where to go.
Alright, you push forward too.
Here I come.
So yeah, this is very XCOM-ish. It's very, very good. I'm enjoying this. Bullshit here and there, but... Not too bad. Oh, is that the guy we're after? I believe that's the guy we're after. You, go help him, go.
Will do. What now?
Escort the engineer to the extraction point. Oh shit, there's the extraction point. Alright. Alright. Well, we're gonna hold position there.
Look out!
Well, we need this guy to move. We need you to move your sorry ass, mister. He's got a pistol. That's good.
Over there?
I don't know if there's going to be any skidders over there, but I think we dealt with most of the skidders over there, so we should be okay otherwise.
Time to move.
Well, I'll push everyone up so they can flank ahead, leaving a couple behind just to protect him. Other than that, push as far as you can go, sir, and we'll protect you the rest of the way. You can run as far as you can go.
Will do.
So yeah, it's not the most fast-paced game, but then again, it's a turn-based game. You know, it's about as fast as a turn-based game can be. Holy Helm, could you scout ahead for us?
Going.
I know you haven't got the greatest health in the world, but I want to know what we're dealing with up there. Right, Laurie.
Let's do this.
You're standing next to him. Right, looks like the Asfenia aren't showing up, but if all the Asfenia were dead, the game would end. Like, the mission would end, so I'm going to imagine that there are some Asfenia out there.
Consider it done.
The fucking noobs are taking ages to catch up. Like, really, really taking a long time to turn up. We're going to have to wait another turn just for these guys to catch up. In the meantime, I'm going to get Holy Helm in another position.
Here I come.
Just hold.
When does the fun part start?
I know, that's what I'm asking. When does the fun part start? Alright, you stay there, I'm gonna bring the noob up. Come on, noob. Hurry up.
You got it.
Well, that's one way to cheese it. Alright, noob's there. Somehow, the pathing in this game is coded incorrectly. Somehow this guy, who was behind this guy, could run further than this guy. They're both the same level. It's very questionable. I'm dubious about pushing Holy Helm up further, but oh, game's over. Well, I'll finish this mission, because I'm actually enjoying this game.
Heard.
I'm going to push her up. Alright. You get up behind her. Shit! There's a fucking skitter in there. I fucking knew it. Alright. Go over
now.
There, go. Sveni, he's gonna come pushing forward. Is he gonna attack the fucking prick? Don't you dare kill him. Yeah, you better run. Don't you dare kill him. Right, you pull back, sir. Actually, does anyone have any explosives? You've got one. That will do nicely. Alright.
Roger that.
Blow that fucker up. Well, first things first. Run over there out of the way. Get to the instruction spot. Unless the mission ends as soon as he gets there. Oh. Mission ends as soon as he gets there. Fair enough. Whatever. So, we got a commission complete, but yeah, we didn't lose anybody. We were going to get another kill, but oh well. That's fine by me. Should have gone halfway. Would have got more XP. I don't know if we get XP based on kills or what. Or XP based on success. I honestly don't know, but all I know is that those two noobs that were level 1 are now level 3. Which is pretty fucking sweet, if I say so myself, so it looks like this guy's a fighter, so oh, sweet, we're going to need him. He's going to cover our area. That's really good. Allows the fighter to attack or defend after sprinting. Defend reduces the fighter's chance to be hit by 40%. And we'll go for a attack. Yeah. Alright, next up, we have a melee weapon which performs a devastating attack at close range. Cannot go wrong. So we got another spiked kid. We'll get the extra utility slot for this one, just to broaden our horizons. Holy Helm, you have unlocked Shrapnel Storm, a vicious shotgun blast that has 25% increased accuracy and crit chance. That doesn't sound so good. Adds a toxin to smoke grenades which poison alien units for 2 turns. Ooh, I like that one. But do you have to have smoke grenades for that? That sounds dubious. I'm not too sure. We'll go for the shotgun blast. Can't go wrong with shotgun blast. Very deadly at close range. Let's see. Intimidating roar causes the target to run away in fear, cowering for 1 turn. An explosive device that also sets fire to the target, causing them burn for 2 turns. I don't know, what would be more useful? A roar or a Molotov? I kind of like damage, but also, that roar could be really fucking useful. It causes the target to run away in fear, cowering for 1 turn. That means for that 1 turn, they won't be able to attack. So we can kill them. Like, we'd shoot them, then roar at them again. I'm going to go for roar. That sounds way too useful. As much as I like having the, you know, the damage. But, yeah. Oh, you can actually get the skills you don't choose for the cost of food. Impressive. I like that. It's a nice little feature. This is a really good game. I really like this one. Research has been completed in the workshop. 4 new volunteers are available to recruit. Alright, so we got the dispatch mission, which is pretty sweet. Yep, we got ourselves some awesome stuff. Gonna go train another recruit, Sally. We'll send them on dispatch. Like, there's no negative to sending them on dispatch. I think they have a chance of not returning at all. No one's died yet. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to save the game because the time is up for this game. So let's move on to the next game now. That was Falling Skies, the game. Pretty freaking awesome. It's a budget XCOM game. If you haven't already got it, get it on PS3, Xbox 360. I don't know if it's out on PC, but definitely pick it up if you can find it. Dirt cheap. I did. And it was definitely worth it. It's a nice, fun little XCOM alternative with a cute little, you know, tie into the TV show. Which, if you're a big fan of the TV show like I am, definitely worth it. So, yeah, pretty cool.